Good afternoon, students. Are you able to see the screen? Is my voice clear? Okay, fine. So today we will be solving numericals based on RL and RC circuits. At the same time, we will study some theory about the combination of R, L and C circuits. So guys, have you understood all the basics up to RL and RC circuits? Like the power triangle, the impedance triangle and the voltage triangle. So that was the last topic that we had covered yesterday. We shall begin today's class from that topic itself, and we'll draw an analogy between both the triangles, that is the voltage triangle and the power triangle, and we'll draw some important formulas from there. So you remember, how does the voltage triangle for an RL circuit look like? This is VR, this is VL, and this is V, right? And how was the power triangle? This is P, this is Q, and this is S. Now, as you all know that these are series circuits, RL series circuit as well as RC series circuit. So the current flowing through the circuit remains the same. So for a given voltage triangle, if I am multiplying I throughout, as I had told you yesterday as well, that we can derive this power triangle either from the voltage triangle or we can derive it from the impedance triangle. Yesterday's derivation was completely based on the impedance triangle. Today we shall be deriving this power triangle from the voltage triangle. So if I multiply this current I is actually the I RMS, and this voltage V is the V RMS or the supply voltage throughout the triangle. So we are actually getting a power, and this power is P, this power is Q, and this power is equal to S. So can we draw an analogy between these two triangles? We can do that. So what are we getting? What are the basic formulas that we can derive based on both these triangles? That the apparent power S is equal to V into I. That is VRMS into IRMS. For a given question, if VRMS and IRMS are mentioned, then you can find out the apparent power directly. What is the active power? Active power is VI cos phi or cos theta, if this angle is theta. Or can I write S cos theta as P? If I am able to write S cos theta is equal to P based on this triangle, then substituting S as VI, I am getting P is equal to VI cos theta. Clear so far? Similarly, I can write S sin theta is equal to Q. Now that is equal to VI sin theta. Clear? The same thing can be done for an RC circuit as well. This is the voltage triangle. The voltage triangle for the RC circuit is, this is VR, this is VC, and this is V. And the power triangle is, this is P, this is Q, and this is S. As this is a series circuit, I can multiply I throughout. And if I draw an analogy between both these triangles, I am getting the same formula, that S is equal to V into I. And this is the angle theta. This theta is called as the power factor angle or the phase angle. Please note this down. This is important. In questions, you can have either calculate phase angle or calculate power factor angle or phase difference. And P is given as S cos theta. Substitute S by VI, so you'll get VI cos theta, and Q you shall be getting as VI sin theta. Clear so far? We had actually noted down these expressions of power in the last slide of our last class, but I thought that you should also know how we can derive this from the voltage and the power triangles. Clear so far? Now you remember that impedance triangle? In impedance, we had derived the power triangle yesterday from the impedance triangle, and we had multiplied I square to it. So can I write this VI cos theta as I square R? This I got it from the impedance triangle. Can I write VI sin theta as I square XL for an RL circuit? And can I write VI as I square Z? Z denotes the total impedance of the circuit. If it is a RL circuit, then what is Z? For an RL circuit, what is Z equal to? Z is equal to R plus J XL. Similarly, for an RC circuit, P is equal to VI cos theta, which is equal to I square R. Q will be I square XC, because this is a RC circuit. What about S? S will be I square Z. And what will be Z for an RC circuit? It is R minus JXC. Clear so far? Now there is one more thing. Before we start solving the numericals, we must know that. That is power factor. You already know that power factor is the cosine of the angle that is present between the voltage and the current. Now this phi or theta, you can also write it as theta. In the triangles we are using this notation as theta. We can also find out this theta value from the triangles. So you remember from the impedance triangle, I am drawing the impedance triangle for our convenience once again. This is R, this is plus JXL, and this is Z, and this is theta. So what is theta equal to? Cos theta is equal to R upon Z. From the voltage triangle, this will be equal to VR upon V. And from the power triangle, this will be equal to P upon S. This cos theta is the power factor of the circuit, or power factor of a combined component. Similarly, if you want to derive the power factor for an RC circuit, remember the impedance triangle. This is R, this is minus JXC, and this is Z, and this was theta. So this is cos theta is equal to R upon Z from the impedance triangle. From the voltage triangle, again you will be getting the same thing, VR upon V, and from the power triangle you will be getting P upon S. And this is the power factor of a circuit comprising of RC. So can you see one thing? Whether it is the power factor or whether it is the power formulas, all are same for inductive as well as capacitive circuit. The only difference that arises in both the circuit is this Z, that is the impedance. If it is an inductor, then it is plus JXL. If it is a capacitor, then it is minus JXL, XC. And this XL is given as omega L, and this XC is given as 1 upon omega C. Alright, now we'll solve few numericals. Just a second, before we solve few numericals, we'll just study the waveform pattern, and then we'll start solving few numericals. These are some important waveforms. Now you remember, this is a simple R circuit which is connected to an AC supply. What was the phasor representation? Since V and I are in phase, so the phasor representation or the vector representation for an R circuit is done like this. Remember for an L circuit, if it is connected to an AC supply, the current lags the voltage by 90 degrees. Clear? Now, what type of circuits are we dealing with? We are dealing with a RL circuit. This is R, this is L. Make sure you close all these lines to make a complete circuit. So how do you expect this phasor representation to be? Now, when it is a resistive circuit, I is in phase with V. The angle between I and V is completely zero. If it is purely inductive circuit, the phase angle between V and I is 90 degree. Now we are considering a RL circuit. So naturally, the phase angle will be something greater than zero but less than 90 degrees. So this is how the phasor would look like. And since no matter whether it is minus 90 degree or it is minus theta, I is lagging V. The moment you discover that I is lagging V, you should always infer that the circuit is inductive in nature. Clear till this part? Right? For an inductive circuit, our waveform was something like this. If this was V or I, it will not start at 90 degree, rather it will start at some angle theta. Understood this part? So this is how the waveforms do differ, and this is how we can differentiate between a simple R circuit, between a simple L circuit, and between a RL circuit. Now let us draw the same type of analogy for an RC circuit as well. Students, is that part clear? I'm moving on with the RC circuit. Okay, fine. Now when in the RC circuit also, we had a simple first R circuit. Now the phasor representation for the R circuit is V and I are in phase with one another. If you have a circuit with only C, then I leads V by 90 degree. Anticlockwise means leading. Right now we have a circuit which is R and C in combination. This is R, this is C, and this is V and F. Now for an R circuit, the angle between I and V is 0 degree. For a RC circuit, the angle between I and V is 90 degree. So what will happen in case of an RC circuit? Naturally, this theta will lie in between 0 to 90. But this time it is positive 0 to 90. What about the waveforms? For a resistive circuit, V and I are in always phase, are in phase. For a capacitive circuit, if this is V, then I leads V by 90 degrees. Now, what will happen in case of RC circuit? If this is V, then I will not lead by 90 degree, rather I will start leading at some angle theta. This is I. Clear so far? So for R, we can see the representation. They are in phase. For only C, I is leading V by 90 degree, and when it is an RC circuit, it will start leading. And yes, in the phasor diagram, when you see that I is leading V by any angle, whether that angle is even 1 degree, you have to infer that the circuit is capacitive in nature. Just like if it is lagging by 1 degree, you have to infer that it is inductive in nature. Similarly, otherwise you have to do when it is a capacitive one. Done. Let us now move on to solve few numericals. The first two numericals are based on RL circuit and the last one is based on RC circuit. Now this is the question. This is the question that we have. A coil having a resistance of 7 ohms and an inductance of 31.8 ohms. Millihenry. I'm very sorry. Inductance unit is always in henries. If you are finding out the inductive reactance, then the unit is in ohms. So a coil having a resistance of 7 ohms. The first thing that you should come across this question is, it says it is a coil. So you remember what a coil is? A coil means it is not purely inductive in nature, rather it will have a small resistance in series with the inductor. So it's given R and this is L. R is given out to be 7 ohms and L is given as 31.8 millihenries. It is connected across 230 volts, 50 hertz supply. This is the single AC frequency and this is the supply voltage. And this supply voltage is actually V or VRMS. Now what is it asking? It is asking us to find out the circuit current. The circuit current means this is a current that will flow through a circuit. Since this is a series circuit, the current flowing through the circuit remains the same. And this I is actually IRMS. Then find out the phase angle. You know what is phase angle? Phase angle means power factor angle or the phase difference, that is phi. What is power factor? Power factor will be cos phi. And what will be power consumed? Power consumed means is the real power, that is P, that which will be VI cos phi. Now if you guys are able to solve it, then please solve it and post your answers. At the same time, I am solving over here. So first, going with the circuit current, how do I find out the current? Current is given as V upon Z. Now since this is a RL circuit, what is the Z? V is 230 volts, Z is R plus JXL. Why is it plus JXL? It is because the impedance shown by this inductor is plus JXL and the impedance shown by this resistor is R. It's a series circuit, so combine both the resistance as well as the reactance. So the net impedance is R plus JXL. So it will be 230 upon R is given as 7 plus J omega L. So we first need to figure out what is omega L. What will be omega L? It is 2 pi F into L, which is 2 pi into 50 into 31.8. Students, please remember that the value of this inductance is given in millihenries. So you must multiply 10 raised to the power minus 3 and bring all the units to their standard units. Now this one comes out to be closely equal to 10 ohms. So this is 230 upon 7 plus J 10. Now all of you have their calci with them. This is a rectangular way of representing this impedance. I want all of you to convert this to the polar form. If you are converting this to the polar form, you will be getting something like this. It will be 12.2 angle 55 degrees. Now why is it important to convert this thing to the polar form? Because we need the angle, and this angle is actually the power factor angle. The angle that is with the impedance finally goes with the current. The current will start carrying the angle that is actually being carried by the impedance, because our voltage is at angle zero. So whatever angle this Z will be carrying, that actually comes to the current. And this angle, when goes to the numerator, comes with a negative sign. So this value comes out to be 18.84 angle minus 55 degrees. Now here there are two things that you must infer. What are they? When you are finding out the polar form of the Z, Z is having a positive angle. Z having a positive angle means circuit is inductive. And if Z is having a positive angle, that clearly implies that I will carry a negative angle. And that also shows that the circuit is inductive in nature. You must understand these two things. For an inductive circuit, the impedance will have a positive angle. At the same time, the current due to that positive angle of the impedance will start carrying a negative angle. And in both the cases, the circuit is inductive in nature. Is this thing clear? Class, please reply yes or no if you can catch up till this part. Next is the phase angle. What will be the phase angle? It is phi. Now phi is always positive. Please remember, phi is always positive. Yes, Rudir, it is 18.84. Very good. Phi is always positive. The only thing that you are supposed to do is, if you are getting a negative angle of I with respect to V, then you are supposed to write it as lag. The lead and lag will give us an inference whether that angle was positive or negative. Otherwise, the numerical value of this phi is always positive. So this phi is coming out to be 55 degrees in bracket, please write lag. And what will be the power factor? The power factor will come out to be cos phi. That is cos of 55 degrees. I repeat here, this is 55 degrees, not radians. If you are working out in radians, then make sure you are working it from the beginning itself. Do not change degree to radians, radians to degrees in between. And it is preferable that you go with degrees only. Cos phi, cos 55 degrees would come out to be 0.574. And please write lagging or leading for power factor as well. For both these things, for phi as well as for the power factor, please write, I am not sure what this person's name is. Initials are written as PK. PK, your current values are perfectly correct. It's absolutely correct. And find out that phase angle and the power factor. And finally, you are supposed to find out the power consumed. I'll scroll a bit down. So what will be the power consumed? Power consumed is actually the real power or active power P, which is given as VI cos phi or cos theta, which is 230 into 18.84. Cos phi came out to be 0.574. Now when you're computing the power, you need not write here lag or lead. That is not required. These things are not required because it is already understood you are computing only the real power, and that will come out to be 2487.26 watts, or you can write 2.487 kilowatts. Alright, so this is how you have to solve it. Class, is this question clear to all? Can we move on to the next question? Okay. So what does this next question says? A current of 5 amps flows through a non-inductive resistance. Whenever you solve these questions from single phase AC circuit, you have to come across these type of terms. So you have to be very clear what are you going to draw. Non-inductive resistance. Non-inductive resistance means it is simply saying that it is a resistor. There is no coil or no inductor in series with it. So there is a non-inductive resistor in series with a choking coil. Now what is a choking coil? Choking coil means a small resistance in series with an inductor. This is a choking coil. Coil or a choking coil. Supplied at 250 volts. So the supply voltage is 250 volts. Now, instead of clearly mentioning this as the frequency, it is given as 50 cycles per second. So you need to understand that this is the frequency with a value of 50. Now, if the voltage, we need to write this thing as well. It's already mentioned that a current of 5 amps is flowing. This is a series circuit, means the entire current flowing through the circuit is 5 amps. This is the resistor R. The voltage across the R is 125 volts. And across the coil, by coil it means across this entire combination, the voltage is 200 volts. This is R. And yes, how do you denote the non-inductive resistance? Actually, the one which is represented as the only R should be denoted by capital R. And the resistance which is present along with the inductor representing a coil, that should be always denoted as small r. Whether it in case with a capacitor or with an inductor, this R should be always small, and capital R should be always the non-inductive resistance. And this is the L. Now what does it say? Is calculate the impedance, reactance, resistance of the coil. Which one is the coil? This entire block is the coil. It is asking us to find out, I'm writing it over here, what are we required to find out? Z of the coil. What is Z of the coil? Small r plus j xl. Reactance of the coil. What is reactance of the coil? xl. Resistance of the coil, which is small r. The next is find out the power absorbed by the coil. Power absorbed, consumed, active power, real power, they are all synonyms. They represent one simple meaning, that is the power that is being dissipated by the resistors. So since it is saying power absorbed by the coil, please note this, it says that power absorbed by the coil. So what will be the power? It will be I square into small r. And in case of this coil, had the word circuit been written, so what will be the power absorbed by the circuit? I square whole into capital R plus small r. The power absorbed by the circuit will be the current flowing through all the resistances that are present in the circuit. But right now in the question, it is only asking for this power absorbed by the coil. Next is the power factor of the coil. Power factor of the coil can be found out from the impedance triangle formula, small r upon z. And if you are having trouble in finding out the power factor using this formula, then you can just find out z of this coil, convert this rectangular thing into the polar form, whatever is the angle is the power factor. And finally, we have to represent a phasor diagram. So let us start solving this numerical. Absorb power means it is consuming power. It is a real power. Dissipation of heat means someone has absorbed power and is dissipating in the form of heat. L or C, they are never able to absorb any sort of power. Okay, let us start solving with this numerical. So what is the first thing we are supposed to do? V across R is given as 125 volts. Now since this is the voltage across one particular element R, can I write this as I into R? And I is this current that is flowing through the entire circuit, and it is being presented with a value of 5 amps. So from here we can find out R, which comes out to be 25 ohms. Next is we are given with V with of the coil. So V of the coil can be written as I into Z of the coil. So Z of the coil is equal to, it is Z of the coil. There it is Z of the coil, not the total Z. We'll solve this. When we'll solve this, you'll figure out. If the term coil is used, means we have to go everything of the coil, nothing of the circuits. Z of the coil can be found out from this expression. V of the coil is given is 200 and current is 5. So 200 upon 5 is 40 ohms. Now there is one more expression we can use. What is that? This. The total V is given and this is the total Z. So can I write one more formula, that V is equal to I into Z total? So Z total comes out to be yes, they have asked power factor of the coil only, but right now while solving the numerical we'll find out the power factor of the coil as well as of the circuit, because in exam you can have any type of question. Z total will come out to be 50 ohms. Clear so far? Now see here. Now this Z coil, which came out to be 40 ohms, can I write this Z coil as R plus JXL? If I want the magnitude of this Z coil, then it can be written as mod of Z coil as root over of R square plus XL square. Similarly, this will be equation 1. Similarly, for Z total, we can write Z total equals to capital R plus small r plus JXL. If I want to figure out the magnitude of this Z total, then it can be represented as under root of, take all the real parts together, that is capital R plus small r square plus XL square. This is equation 2. Clear? Now solve these equation 1 and 2. How do you solve it? I'm scrolling down a bit. How do you solve this? I can write x r square. This equation 1 can be rewritten as r square plus xl square is equal to 40 square. This is equation 1. Capital R value is already known to us as 25 plus small r square plus xl square is equal to 50 square. This is equation 2. From solving 1 and 2, one obtains these values. Small r comes out to be 5.5 ohms and XL will come out to be 39.62 ohms. Clear so far? Now once you know R and XL, we can find out what is Z coil, because we already know what is Z coil. Z coil is given as R plus JXL. Since we already have obtained what is small r and what is XL, which has come out to be 39.62, so this is your Z coil. And there is one important note over here. See, already you had obtained the value of Z coil to be 40 ohms, but that was the magnitude of the Z coil. In the exam, if this question is being asked to you, please do not write the value of Z coil as 40 ohms. This is the value of Z coil. And if you want to write it in the terms of magnitude, then you have to write its angle as well. If you convert this rectangular value to a polar value, then you will get a value of 40 angle 82.097 degrees ohms. So this is the value of Z coil. Please do not write in the exam that this came out to be 40 ohms, so you'll just write 40 ohms. It's better you write the value, the magnitude along with the angle. The actual answer would come out to be 39.999 angle 82.0967 degrees. Now this thing can be written as 40 ohms. Now you have already obtained Z coil. We already know the value of R. We already know the value of XL. Next, we are supposed to find out what is the power absorbed by the coil. Power absorbed by the coil is given as I square into small r. because within the coil we have only one resistive component, that is small r. So the value of I is known to us 5 square and r came out to be 5.5. Yes PK, your answer is absolutely correct. Whenever you write the angle, like you have written here the 39.999 angle 82.096 lead. Now what does lead mean in case of a Z? There is no meaning of this word lag or lead when you are representing the angle with respect to Z. This lead or lag has a role to play only when you are writing the angle with respect to I. So refrain from writing that lead or lag with respect to the angle that has come out with respect to Z. So 5 square into 5.5, which will come out to be 137.5 watts. Now over here, as I said, we'll also find out the power absorbed by the circuit. Power absorbed by the total circuit will come out to be I square into capital R plus small r. 5 square into capital R has a value of 25 plus 5.5. Together they make 30.5. So it will come out to be 762.5 watts. Got it? The next was power factor of the coil. Now how was the coil represented? The coil was represented like this, R, and this is plus JXL. Using the impedance triangle, the power factor of the coil would be given as the R upon the Z of the coil. R is 5.5 and the magnitude, only the magnitude. Now we don't require the angle because we already know whether it is leading or lagging, and since it is having a positive angle with Z means it is actually a lagging circuit or an inductive circuit. So the power factor will come out to be 0.13575 lag. Please write lead or lag when you are writing the power factor. See, you must write lead lags with these parameters, with I, with phi, and with power factor. Is my screen still? Can you see the screen now? Okay, fine. So you were able to see this I and phi and the power factor, right? And have you filled the attendance sheet? What about the attendance sheet? I'm closing the link right now. Okay, fine. All right. Okay, so did you figure out? Okay, thank you. You have all filled. Very good. So did you figure out what will be the value of I? No, I'm sorry. It was not about I. I was saying something else. I was telling you that this lead and lag thing are to be written with certain parameters, right? Lead and lag thing is to be written with certain parameters. And these are the parameters. If it is current, then please write it is lead or lag. If it is phi, phase difference, then write lead or lag. If it is power factor, then please write it is lead or lag. Apart from these three parameters, do not write this term lead or lag anywhere, because our basic fundamental is the current lags the voltage, then it is inductive, and if the current leads the voltage, then it is capacitive. Okay, was there anyone who was able to find out the power factor of the total circuit? Of the total circuit. I'll be scrolling down a bit. Power factor of the Yes, Sushma, it's working. It is, I have a second screen. I can see it's working. Please refresh it. It's working. Please let me know if it's working or not. Okay, fine. So the power factor of the circuit, how do you figure out the power factor of the circuit? What was the total circuit? There is a non-inductive resistor. Yes, there you're absolutely correct. It's 0.61. There is a non-inductive resistor R in series with a choke coil, that is RL, small r and L. So power factor of the circuit will be capital R plus small r by Z total. Over here, you would require the magnitude part only. So it is 25.5.5 upon 50. That will come out to be 0.61 lag. Clear? Yes, there you are right. It's 0.61. Power factor is leading. No, Rakesh, power factor is not leading. It is lagging. If the angle of Z, I'm scrolling up for some time. If the angle of Z comes out positive, if it comes out positive, then when you are finding out I, which is I upon V, I is V upon Z, naturally this I will carry an angle which is negative. So this leading and lagging thing depends on the angle of the I. It has nothing to do with the angle of Z. If Z is having a positive angle, means I is definitely having a negative angle, so this is a lagging circuit or an inductor circuit. And anyway, it is already given that it is a coil, so it has to be inductive and it will lag. Alright, so power factor of the total circuit comes out to be 0.61 lag. Now the last bit of the question was, find out the phasor diagram. How would you find out the phasor diagram? Since this is a series circuit, you require one more resistor. Since this is a series circuit, the current flowing through the circuit remains the same. So I can take my current as a reference. Now, what are the voltages that will lie along this current? This voltage is VR, this voltage is small V, V small r, and this is VL. What are the voltages which will lie along this current? First is VR. Is there any other resistive voltage? Yes, small VR. So that is in series. All the real part of the circuit should lie along the real axis, and all the imaginary part of the voltages will lie on the imaginary axis, depending whether it is plus J or minus J. So there will be an addition, and that addition part is given by small VR. Next voltage is VL. Now, what is the relationship of the current when it is passing through an inductive circuit? I lags V by 90 degrees. So, since I is the reference, this will be VL. Now, if we join the tail of VR with the head of VL, we get the net V. This V is V supply or the VRMS. And if you join the tail of small VR with this V head of the V coil, what do you get? You get V of the coil. Clear? Now we'll move on to a next question. If there is any doubt, you please let me know. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is a voltage of 125 volts at 50 hertz is applied across a non-inductive resistor. Now please mark this. in almost all the questions you will come across these terms: non-inductive resistor, choke coil, coil. So these things have been explained to you in the last class, probably that the class which was held yesterday in the initial part. So non-inductive resistor means only a resistor. It is in series with a capacitor. So here there is a non-inductive resistor. Non-inductive resistor means it has to be represented by capital R, and the capacitor part with a capital C. Now the voltage is given to be 125 volts and the frequency is required. Anything else is given? Yes, the current is given, so it is 2.2 amps. And one more information is also being provided to us. The power loss in the resistor is 96.8 watts. So what can you write for this? We can write I square capital R is 96.8. And the value of I is known to you. So we can find out R directly from this formula itself, and it will come out to be 20 ohms. Basically, this question is asking you to find out the value of this resistance and find out the value of this capacitance. Finding out R is mostly easy. In most of the questions, finding out R is basically very easy. Now we need to find out this capacitance. How can we use the rest of the information? Now we know one thing, that V is equal to IZ. V means this total V, or VRMS is equal to IZ. You can write here Z total, or you can just write Z. And what is Z for RC? Now Z for R is R, and Z for C is minus JXC. This is connected in series, so add them up. R minus JXC. So Z is equal to V upon I. 125 upon 2.2, this comes out to be 56.82 amps. So the magnitude part of the Z is known to us, but we require the angle. If we do not know the angle, then we won't be able to formulate this. Just a second. In this question, we do not need any angle. We do not require any angle. Just write here Z is equal to square root of R square plus XC square. The value of R is known to us. So we can write here Z square is equal to R square plus XC square, and we can find out the value of XC, which is equal to Z square minus R square under root. And that will come out to be 53.18 ohms. So once you have the value of this XC, you have been actually asked to figure out. Yes, Prathamesh, you are absolutely correct. 56.82 is the value of Z. You have to find out the value of capacitance. So capacitance, what is the expression of XC? XC is given as 1 upon omega C, where omega can be written as 2 pi F. So I need to scroll down a bit. So XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi F C. So C will come out to be 1 upon 2 pi F into XC, and that would come out to be 59.85 microfarads. Clear? Yes, Sheikh Mohammed, what is in ohms? You're asking something in ohms. The unit for C is in farads. It will come out to be as microfarads. Yes, Nayan, your answer is absolutely correct. And the unit of XC or XL is in ohms. All right, clear so far? Yes, Darya, you're right. Please write the unit after the value. Students, I have to... Yes, Rudhir, you are also correct. It's 59.85 microfarads. Students, let me know of one thing. I have to teach you the basics of RLC, which will take another 10 minutes or so. So do you want to continue or do you want to wrap up for today? Yes, Raj, your answer is correct. Please let me know. Just the basics of RLC so that we can start solving those numericals. Basically, in the exams, you will have numericals where the components would be a combination, series combination of RLC. Let me know. Should I take 10 more minutes to just explain you the basics of RLC? Will not go with any numericals. Or do you want to wrap up right now? Okay, some of you are saying to continue. Okay, give me just 10 more minutes and we'll be done with the RLC. Alright, so you already know about the series, you already know about the RL, RC and individual RL and C circuit. Okay, since I've just started, let me just give you a brief introduction. Yes, Darya, I'm planning to keep the lectures at least daily, weekdays, yes. Let me at least explain you the basics, then we are done with the class. So we are going to start with this R, L and C circuits. So how will this R, L and C look like? This is R, this is L and this is C. Yes, Rajan, the lectures will be held daily. R, L and this is C and this is V, that is V RMS with along with the frequency. The current flowing through the circuit will be I, which will be I RMS. So what is the impedance for this resistor? The impedance for this resistor is given as, things remain the same, R. The impedance for L will be given as plus jXL and for C it will be given as minus jXC. So what is the net impedance of this series RLC combination? The net impedance will be R, since this is series, so you have to add all together, R plus jXC, XL, not C, minus jXC, that is the net impedance. Press, the voltage across this R remains as VR, the voltage across this L remains VL, the voltage across this C remains VC. Now, once you have written down this expression, Z expression, that is R plus jXL minus jXC, two cases will arise. There are two cases that will arise. One is XL can be greater than XC. And the other case is XC can be greater than XL. Why is there a situation for two cases? It's because in the same circuit, we are having two reactances present. One is due to L, one is due to C. So if this reactance is greater than the other reactance, the circuit becomes inductive in nature. That is, if XL is greater than XC, the circuit becomes inductive in nature. And if XC is greater than XL, then the circuit becomes capacitive in nature. These are thus the theoretical explanations. Once you start solving the numericals, you will be able to understand whether it is the final lead or the final lag. The final lead or final lag can be known to you only with the angle of I. If the final angle with I comes out to be negative, means it is inductive. And if the final angle with I comes out to be positive, means the circuit is capacitive. That is the only thing. Yes, there you are right. The next circuit will be either inductive or capacitive depending on these reactance values. So in order to know that while solving numericals, you have to check these two things. You have to basically check the parameter I and its respective angle, whether it is negative or whether it is positive. Now, once you have derived these two cases, again we have to draw three triangles. You know what those triangles are. One is the voltage triangle, one is the impedance triangle, one is the power triangle. So I'm drawing it. How will your voltage triangle look like? This is VR. Since the circuit will be inductive in nature, obviously the VL will point upward and it will be greater than VC. So this will be VL minus VC and this will be net V. For this capacitive side, this one will be VR. Since the net circuit is capacitive in nature, VC will be greater than VL. So this will be VC minus VL and this is V. So this is the voltage triangle and this angle phi or theta is the power factor angle. Not right now. PK is asking, yes, Rudhir is also asking, it can be purely resistive. So that is altogether a different condition or a different phenomena, which we call it as resonance. We'll study that later on. Right now we are just studying about a normal RLC circuit. Now when XL becomes equal to XC, we call that as resonance. Right now we are not considering that. That would be in the subsequent classes. Right now we're just discussing the general aspect of a series RLC circuit. Okay, so this angle will be your power factor angle. Now how will you draw the impedance triangle? This will be your R, this will be your reactance. Since it is inductive in nature, so XL will be greater than XC, so it is XL minus XC, and this is Z. Again, this is your power factor phi. Similarly for capacitive, this is R, this is XC minus XL, and this is Z. This is phi. The final triangle will be your power triangle. This is P. This is, now this Q is actually the QL minus QC, but we have to write it as the net power as Q. But this is Q net, which will come out first, the power due to the inductive component minus power due to the capacitive component. And this is S. And the final power triangle for here will be P. This is Q and this is S. And these are the power factor angles. So what can we infer about the power factor from all these three triangles? Cos phi can be written as VR upon V, or it can be written as R upon Z or P upon S. Is this clear? If you want, I can give you a numerical as homework and you can just solve it and keep it with you and we can discuss it tomorrow. Do you want a numerical as homework? Or should we stop here and start solving tomorrow itself? I'm unable to figure out that should I be giving you a numerical as homework or as an assignment or something like that. Okay, PK says, okay, someone is saying numerical, yes, few of them are saying tomorrow. Fine. If possible, I'll make one assignment sheet for you and I'll give it to the CRs to circulate in the group. And tomorrow we can start afresh, right? Please give us, okay. Tomorrow give us one numerical. Alright, fine. Let us do one thing. I'm just calling out one numerical. You can just write it right now and solve it as homework. And let's see. Okay, take down one numerical. There is a coil with a resistance value of 7 ohms. There is an inductor with a value of 31.8 millihenry. I'm not solving the numerical right now. It's for you to solve. This has been given to you as homework. I'll solve it tomorrow. There are a few changes in the values. Don't write these values. These have been already used in the previous examples. Take R as 20 and inductor as 0.05 henries and a capacitor of 50 microfarads. Fine, they are connected in series. So you know how to draw the circuit. It will be something like this. Voltage, supply voltage is given as 230 volts. With 50 hertz is the supply frequency. You have to calculate the following. Bit 1. Find out the impedance. Now when I say the impedance means it should be the net impedance because it is a series combination of RLC. Bit 2. The current. Current means the total current that is drawn by the circuit. Bit 3. You cannot see the question. Oh, just a second. Is this clear now? Fine. I have scrolled the screen down and you can see it right now. Yes, I've scrolled up. I've done up and down. You can see the screen now. Find out the impedance. So that is the total impedance. Find out the total current. Now when you find out the current, you will definitely have some angle associated with this I, which will tell you whether the circuit is capacitive or it is inductive in nature. So you have to find out phi. Phi means the phase difference or the phase angle or the power factor angle. Bit 4, you have to find out the power factor. Bit 5, you must find out the active power that is represented by P. And bit 6 is the reactive power that is represented by Q. And the expression to find out P and Q are VI cos phi, VI sin phi. But the important things are these. These three bits are very, very important. The angle that will come with I, which will help us to know whether the circuit is capacitive or inductive. Phi, leading or lagging, power factor, leading or lagging. Please take this question as homework, solve it, and we'll meet once again tomorrow then. If there are any more doubts, then please let me know. Students, any doubts? Bye, PK. Thank you. Thank you, Gayatri. Thank you, Bhagyashree. Shubham. Arya, you have a problem regarding the attendance. Alright, we'll see to it. Anayan, tomorrow, when is the class? What is convenient for you guys? Taking classes in the morning is convenient for you or in the afternoon? If I take in the morning, then it will be again at 10 o'clock. And if I take in the afternoon, then it is 4 o'clock. Please let me know which one is convenient for you. Arya says morning, Rucha says morning, Mithilesh morning. Fine, then tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock we'll have this class. Fine? Afternoon. Okay, I'll have a discussion with the CRs and I'll let you know. Fine? Alright. Bye-bye. Take care. Majority says morning. Let's see. Alright, bye. See you.